Hey guys, Peyton Snayback here again for another DVD and Blu-ray update for you guys this week. It's been about 2 weeks since my last one. Not a whole bunch to talk about when it comes to reviewing, but only 9 movies here this week. But I got 7 Blu-rays, 2 DVDs. One of them, well, 2 of them actually being Blu-ray sets, which I'll talk about in a little bit. But I did get 2 Screen Factories and 2 new releases, which were ones I wasn't originally going to get, but, you know, they were in Walmart, so I decided to get them anyway, but, and 2 Steelbooks, actually. So let's go ahead and get started, shall we? So the first one here I got, now, of course, I talk about the Screen Factories, or the Arrow videos, or the Saturn Film movies first, but this movie right here, you know, it's same thing with the other one. Now, these are not good movies, but, you know, they're just ones that you just have to have because you have the original ones, because they're both remakes, but this is the Psycho remake. This is the one, that was released in 1998 with, you know, Gus Van Sant, directed. You know, this is one of those movies where if you've seen the original one, you've seen those, basically, because it's the exact same thing, the exact same script, exact same lines, you know, but basically, if you haven't seen Psycho, you know, or if you haven't seen this, but, you know, it's just basically, you know, lady named Marion Crane, she's, I think she's running away from the police, like, she stole, like, some kind of, like, money, and she ends up staying at the Bates Motel for the night, and, you know, of course, it's run by Norman Bates, you know, this one, Vince Vaughn plays Norman Bates, you know, the original one that was, Anthony Perkins played Norman. He's the original Norman Bates, and always will be the original one. But, you know, of course, she stays there, and of course, everyone knows the scene about the shower, you know, she's taking a shower, and she's getting killed by, apparently, Norman Bates' mother. You know, everyone knows this. Like, it's kind of the exact same thing as the original. Like, if you've seen this one, you've seen this, that's what, like I said, but, this did get released from Screen Factory, you know, the only thing that, you know, the only difference is, of course, you know, obviously the actors, and of course the color, of course, because, you know, the original one didn't have colors, color in it, because it was made in 1960, the only thing that was different about it is because, you know, there was some nudity scenes in it, you know, because, of course, back in the 60s, they weren't allowed to make movies. They weren't allowed to have nudity in movies back then. Because, of course, you know, like, it'll only show, like, a woman wearing a bra, but then that was it. I think that's as much far as they can go. But I think now this is, like, the year I was born, they were allowed to do that stuff now. And the other thing that was kind of cool that I did like, you know, is they had a song that was by Rob Zombie. You know, it was the same song that they had for the intro of Bride of Chucky. I always kind of liked that song. You know, what's her name's also in it? Julianne Moore's in this one, who plays Marion Crane's sister. William H. Macy plays a private investigator. I don't know, I mean, that was the only thing about this I kind of liked, which they changed a little bit of stuff around, you know. But other than that, though, the original one is still the best one. But you do get some cool artwork on this movie, though, on the set, this Blu-ray release. There's, like, a picture of the house, of Bates Motel house. And you get one new special feature on here, which is the audio commentary with editor and the Psycho Legacy writer, director. And, of course, you get all the other features that was in the other DVD, but, you know, it's not very good, but like I said, I just got it just because I had the other ones, you know, but that's that. You know, same thing with this one. By the way, if you guys wonder, this is actually an upgrade to a Blu-ray. Same thing with this one, you know, and these ones, like I said, I didn't have to upgrade because these are not very good movies, but I just wanted to just because I'm running out of stuff to buy, so, but this is kind of the same thing. It's a remake, but it's the exact same script and the exact same lines. But this is the Cabin Fever remake. This is the one that came out a couple of years ago, back in 2016. You know, it's just one of those movies. It's like, why does this thing even exist? Why? You know, what's the whole point? Because, you know, it's... In a sort of a way, this one, if you've seen the other one, you've seen this. But if you haven't seen the Cabin Fever movie, you know, the original one was directed by Eli Roth. You know, he did Hostel. He did The Green Inferno, which I really loved. I don't know what else he did. I think he did a movie called The Stranger. I think he did. And that also came out from Scream Factory, I believe. But, you know, the movie is basically about, you know, a group of these friends. They stay at this cabin, and they get this one by one. They're dying off by this flesh-eating virus, and the water's contaminated with it. But, you know, I gotta say, like, the only thing that's good about this, the only thing out of everything else is the trailer. It seems like these bad movies, the trailer is the good thing about it, you know? I don't know, just the music with the trailer, that's the only thing that was good about it. But I know I did talk to the one actress that was in this, Nadine Crocker, you know, she plays the Marcy character. I don't know, I mean, this is one of those movies you just got to have just because you had the original. That's basically what it is. But this one, I think Eli Roth, yeah, he written the story for this one as well. And this was directed by Travis Z. And the other thing that's really terrible is the acting, you know, because I can kind of see why that there's bad acting in this movie, because it's like, what is the point in doing this now? Because the original one was made in 2003, and this came out 13 years later, in 2016. So it's like, what's the point in doing this? I don't know, it's just like, I don't know, it's just one of those movies. It's just like, why are they doing this? You know, like, what is going on? You know, I don't know, again, but it's one of those ones you just got to have just because. Of course, you get image right here, like Scream Factory always does. Picture of a little kid wearing a bunny mask. I don't know, but this one was just... It was kind of like the Psycho remake as well. Exact same script, exact same lines. I don't know. This wasn't all that good, but just had to have it. Alright, the next one here I got. Now, this is the new release here. You know, this one... You know, I do have two movies I'm going to get rid of, by the way. You know, the remake ones I am going to keep. Because, of course, you know, they're remakes and you just have to have them because it's part of the franchise, you know. But, this one... You know, people warned me not to get this, not to see this. But I did, because I wanted to see how bad it was. And it's pretty awful. And it's one of those movies, it's the same thing, you know. The only thing that's good about it is... the music. And some of the music was pretty decent, but it's the movie Cats here on Blu-ray. This is like the new adaptation. It's based on that play, you know, it came out in 1998. This was released from Universal Studios. You know, this movie was just not that good. But why did I get it? Because I like bad movies. I knew it was going to be bad from the start, but I just wanted to see how bad it was. And it was pretty bad. It was boring, you know. But the movie, it's a musical, basically, you know. It's these people, like, dressed up as cats, and they're doing this musical. I don't know, it just wasn't all that good. You know, it's got a good cast in here. It's got Idris Elba's in this one, Jennifer Hudson. We got Taylor Swift, Reba Wilson, Francesca Hayward. I mean, there's some pretty good actresses in this movie, but overall, it just wasn't that good, you know? So this one I am definitely getting rid of. Alright. Now this next one right here, this one was a little bit better, but I'm still gonna get rid of it because I didn't like it enough to actually give it a rewatch, you know? I did use a digital on it, though, because I may rewatch it on there someday. But this is the the new Kristen Stewart movie, Underwater, here on Blu-ray. And, you know, one of my favorite actors is in this movie. That's mainly why I wanted to see it. What's his name's in it? John Gallagher Jr. You know, he's in this one. You know, he was in the 10 Cloverfield Lane, and he's in another movie I haven't watched yet, but you will see in a future update. He's in a Blumhouse movie called, The Belko Experiment. But again, I have that, and you'll see that in a future update. You know, this is one of, I mean, like I said, this is not the best, but it was a little bit better than Cats, but it wasn't, like, a movie, like I said, I would want to rewatch again, but this is like, you know, it's basically, you know, these people are, like, under, like, water, basically. They're, like, in this, like, submarine, like, surface thing. I don't know what it's called exactly, but, and the whole idea of the thing is, it's collapsing. Well, not collapsing, but it's, like, yeah, basically, it's collapsing, and, you know, the water's coming in the thing, and, you know, they're trying to get out, and, of course, like, there's, like, these monsters in the water. I don't know, I didn't really care for this one that much. I thought it was alright, you know? Not perfect, but it was just alright. Yeah, but that's that. Alright, the next one here, now I'm going to the steelbooks. These are the steelbooks I got. This one right here, you know, I really love these movies. You know, I've seen both of them in theaters. You know, they're just fun movies to watch, you know. But this is Ted 2 here on Blu-ray, the steelbook. You guys want to see what it looks like. Here's the back right here. And, of course, this one has, like, the DVD copy as well. Like, here's the Blu-ray. Of course, there's, like, some images on the back here. That would be my cat wanting to come in. I'll let her in a sec. But, the movie, and of course, this is actually the sequel to the first movie, which, if you haven't seen the first one, it's, you know, basically, starts off with, you know, Mark Wahlberg's character as a kid. You know, he makes a wish, that his teddy bear would come to life because, like, he didn't have any friends when he was a kid. He always got picked on. And, of course, the next day, the dream came true. His teddy bear's alive. And he's been hanging out with his teddy bear all of his life, you know. And you know, the bear is voiced by Seth MacFarlane, you know, who does the voice of, what's his name? I never watched the show that much. Peter Griffin from, you know, a Family Guy. But, of course, like, you know, that's kind of, like, what the whole, you know, the story was with that one. It was, like, you know, he's about to be married, but, you know, the problem is his girlfriend doesn't want him to hang around with the bear anymore, because, like, the bear is kind of, like, in a way, it's in the way of their life, basically. But this one, however, this is basically, about, you know, the, Ted, now he's married to this girl. I forgot what her name is in the movie, but, well, her name is Tammy Lynn in the movie. I don't know what her real name is in life, but they're married, and you know, they're having, like, marital problems, and like, they're always fighting a lot, and they have an idea on maybe they should just get a baby. You know, maybe that would help solve the problems. And you know, the problem is, like, he's a teddy bear, of course, you know, and she's, like, he's just property, and she's a human, of course, you know. It's like, how can a teddy bear mate with a human, of course, you know. That's, and, like, they're doing all these ridiculous things just to get a baby. Like, they try to adopt one, but the problem is they can't get it because, of course, Ted is not considered a human. He's just considered property, and, you know, trying to fight in court to let everyone know that he's actually a human, just so that he can get a kid. I don't know, it was kind of a fun movie to watch, you know. You get some cool cameos in this, like, you know, Amanda Seyfried doesn't make a cameo, but she's mainly, like, a star in the movie, you know. Morgan Freeman makes a cameo in this. I don't know. It was just a fun movie to watch. These are both fun movies to watch. Hopefully, maybe they could do a third one day, which, I don't know, maybe. We'll have to see. But, that is Ted 2 here on Blu-ray. Alright, the next one here I got, this is the other Steelbook. And, this is actually the movie set, that I got. I mainly wanted to get this because it's the Universal Classic Monsters collection here on Blu-ray, Steelbook. Show you what it looks like. It's a six, this set. Bear with me here. But here's the back right here. And, here's the, inside. Like, you get all the characters from the movie. But this set includes every movie except for, The Creature from the Black Lagoon. But, but mainly why I wanted to get this was because the original Frankenstein was in this movie. I kind of really wanted to see that one. But you get Frankenstein, The Bride of Frankenstein, The Invisible Man, The Mummy, Dracula, and The Wolfman. The only movies I really cared for is, of course, the Frankenstein movies and The Invisible Man. I don't know, I didn't really like the other ones that much. But, of course, I did, when it comes to the Invisible Man movie, I did, of course, see that one. I did review it to you guys. I thought that was a really well-done remake. Better than these two. Except the fact that, you know, the original Invisible Man and the remake thing, they were both different things. It had, like, both different, like, storylines. That's what I liked about the remake, because it was really well done. It wasn't kind of like, remaking the whole thing. It was doing its own thing. And, of course, you know, Frankenstein and, you know, the continuing sequel to Frankenstein, Bride of Frankenstein's in this. Everyone knows these movies if you've seen them. These are just fun movies to watch, you know? Okay, now the last one on Blu-ray I got, this is the other set I got. Now this one I had months ago, but I decided to finish this one now, because this is why it took so long, because I had these, movie box sets, that I wanted to get done and finished, because I had them for a while, and I hadn't even watched them yet. That's why I don't have that much in the update. But this is the Fast and Furious collection here on, Blu-ray. And this set you get, from the original one all the way to, The Fate of the Furious, which that was the only one I haven't seen. Well, that and, Hobbs and Shaw, but I don't know if I have to see Hobbs and Shaw. Is that part of the series? Let me know down below if that is, because, I don't know exactly, because I know, like, Part 9's gonna come out. It was, but now, you know, this stuff's going on. It's not gonna come out now, but later in the future. But when it comes to Part 9, I do want to see that one. But I want to know if I have to see Hobbs and Shaw first. But this one, of course, you know, these are movies everyone knows what these are. You know, it's about these are, like, action, like, thriller movies, you know. You know, this one, you know, has, like, The Rock in it, you know, Vin Diesel is in this, Paul Walker, you know, these are just fun movies to watch, and, you know, Tyrese Gibson's in these movies, you know, and the only reason I like him was because, you know, he did a cameo, he was a guest star at a Blue's Clues episode, I don't know, if you guys want to know what it looks like, I mean, there's really nothing much to show, it's just, like, all the movies that are on here, and basically it's an 8-disc set right here. Sorry, you can't see. And you get a bonus disc as well. That's basically what it is. But everyone knows these movies if you haven't seen them. I mean, they're not... Well, it's not like my favorite franchise, but, you know, they're fun movies to watch. But I am gonna keep that one. Alright, now on to the DVDs. I just only got two, and both of them are, TV shows. Alright, now these first ones right here, these ones I finally did get done. Now these ones, when it comes to these ones, they were out of print, but I think it was back in November, I found them on the Amazon website, for like $20, so, and they were brand new. So I don't know, to be honest, if these ones are officially out of print now. because I don't know if they just re-released them now, but it's you know, Zoey 101, season 3 here on DVD, and the reason for, you know, there is two, but the reason for that is because it was a 5-disc set, which I don't know why they couldn't just put them all 5 in one set, you know, but of course, this is, you know, season 3 volume 1, and of course, this is season 3 volume 2, and of course, they're, like I said, they're burn on demand. In case you guys want to know what they look like, they're actually not, they're not press disc. They're actually DVD-Rs. But they're in good quality, though, for burn on demand. But in case if you guys haven't seen the show, you know, it was a Nickelodeon show that came on back in, like, 2005, and it's basically about a girl named Zoey Brooks. You know, Jamie Lynn Spears, Britney Spears' sister plays, you know, the role. No, it's them going, her and her friends, like, have, like, dealing with, like, certain situations and, you know, love connections that's going on in the school. You know, they stay at a school, at a boarding school called PCA, you know. Like, they have this one character named Mark Delfiglio, who, their friend Quinn likes. You know, Quinn, does, like, all these inventions, you know, Chase is in love with Zoey, and Logan's like an asshole, you know, he's like the rich person, you know, his dad's rich, but he gets like a $1,000 like allowance or something. But I don't know, it's just like a show that it's a fun show to watch, you know, and you know, there is talks about a reboot of the show, and I would really love to see where they are now. And I did see that one clip that they uploaded 5 years ago on YouTube, which was kind of like a 10th anniversary to the one episode. It's not on here. It's on season 2, though. what's it called? The time capsule when, they put, like, a CD of, like, their, like, secrets or something, and, I don't know. I forgot how that episode went, but they did, like, a 10th anniversary of that, like, years ago, and it was kind of interesting seeing those two characters come back, though. But really fun show. But if you guys do find these, I suggest you probably get them, because I mean, I'm not sure exactly if they, because they were out of print, they were hard to find, but now it's like they're in print again. So I mean, I don't know, are they in print again? Let me know down below again. But such a fun show to watch. and the last one here I got. You know, and when it comes to the show, I hadn't bought a season of the show in, like, in a couple years, because, you know, I stopped buying them because, you know, the fact that they weren't, when I heard that they weren't going to do them anymore, and I'm surprised they're doing them again. But this is, of course, you know, this is the new season that came out. The Simpsons, the 19th season here on DVD. And I did get all the seasons that came out the Blu-ray, so you'll see those in a future update. But this is the 19th season. And if you want to know what it looks like in the set, that's what it looks like on the back. And, of course, has this, like I said, it shows this thing here. And you can open it from on the top or bottom, but I like to open it on the bottom, or the top. It's a 4-disc set, in case you guys are wondering. What it looks like on that side, and on the other side, you get some artwork on the other side as well. Making sure you guys can see that. And the disc, where are the discs, you're wondering? They actually are inside these things right here. Let me just slide them out like this, and they slide out really easily, so I don't think you're gonna have a problem with them getting scratched. And of course, the episode guide is right in here. I don't want to get it out because it's kind of hard to get back in, you know. But you know, everyone knows what this show is. You know, Bart Simpson always getting in trouble. You know, Lisa Simpson is like the smart one who always gets straight A's. Homer is just a lazy pig, basically. I don't know. It's a fun show to watch. You know, I like the show just as much as South Park, and, you know, Beavis and Butthead. Those are the shows I really like to watch, when it comes to, like, shows like this, you know. But Family Guy, I know lots of people like Family Guy more than, like, South Park and that stuff. I don't know. I mean, Family Guy is an okay show. I never really watched that much episodes. I mean, I don't know. I've just never been a big fan of it. Yep, but that is The Simpsons Season 19 here on DVD. And that is it for this DVD and Blu-ray update. I'm sorry that there's not much this week, but hopefully there is going to be a lot this week. But what's going to happen next week? Because I'm going to try, because I got a lot of DVDs I haven't watched yet, so there's going to be more DVDs than Blu-rays. I think, as far as I know, there's only going to be like 4 Blu-rays in the update and like 10 DVDs. I don't know, but we'll just have to see how many I get next update. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.